Viewers, you are watching the Policy Times and I am Akram Haq, your host. I am here at the residence of Mr. Shri Ripun Bora, who is our Honorable Member of Parliament from the state of Assam and is a Rajya Sabha MP. And he has raised a very important issue today at the Rajya Sabha, at the Parliament. Sir, thank you so much for giving us your bites. So what was the issue that you raised today, sir, at the Parliament?
No, you see, today we have raised the issue. I gave 0 hour in the Parliament, in the Rajya Sabha. The issue was that is this alarming situation of flood in Assam. Of course, flood is a very regular phenomenon in Assam. Every year comes, but this year exceptional is this, that the state government of the BJP state government is totally collapsed to combat with the flood situation. Why? This is because every year it is the government, it is known fact that a flood will come. So government should be prepared, government should have some contingent advance plan. But this time, the BJP government has failed to take any contingent plan. As a result of what happened, when the flood came, the government was in panic, what to do and what not to do. Because the most of the government employees, they have been engaged in the NRC work around the clock. That is number one. And the number two, the government has no preparation. The flood came in such a way, now you see, out of 33 districts, 26 districts have been affected, number one, and 26 lakhs population have been affected. Out of that, 4 lakhs have been displaced, then 15 persons have been died so far, and 3 children are among them. And the most horrible factor is that government has no preparation to immediately open relief camp. So people are taking shelter on national highway and this embankment, and no adequate relief. So it's such a massive way these people affected. Government is giving relief, but it is very meager. Not has failed to give relief to all the affected people.
Right.
So this is, then there is no drinking water. Government has never thought that there should be this type of situation. There's a scarcity of drinking now. There is a serious condition about drinking water. Then the medical team, medical facilities, it is also not there. So in this way, the entire situation has become, it is like a very horrible, it has created havoc. This is one part. And second part, you see, what is the failure of the state government and the BJP government here at center? You see, the BJP government here, they are so insensitive. They are so irresponsible, and state government is also so irresponsible. There is no coordination. They could not demand this national disaster management fund.
Right.
That fund for the last 2 years has not been released to Assam, which is due here.
Mm-hmm.
Then CRF, calamity relief fund, that fund has also not been released for the last 2 years. So because of that, now government is facing serious financial crisis. And this NDRF fund also, that has also been not sent.
Right.
Now you see the attitude of the BJP government, such a huge people have been affected, lakhs and lakhs. But the NDRF jawans, only 12 NDRF jawans have been rushed to Assam. What these 12 NDRF jawans will do? Where this question of lakhs and lakhs people have been marooned, they have been rescued, they are to be rescued. So considering all these things, so today we staged one protest dharna in order to bring this entire issue to the notice of the Prime Minister as well as to the country, to the nation. And secondly, I raised a 0 hour motion in the Parliament itself in order to bring to the notice of the government as well as to the country. So this is the present situation.
So that's a wonderful step that you have taken at the Parliament, sir. But do you now we have the state government and central government comes from the same party, so we can expect speedy actually actions from the party. Do you see that any action has been taken positive?
No, you see, that's why it is this havoc situation now. This for this last 10 days continuously, flood is going. No central team has been deputed so far. Today I have demanded that immediate one central team should rush there to guide and to guide and to take stock of the situation, to guide and help the Assam government. Right. You see, not a single central minister has visited this time. This during election campaign, Modi said he visited 20 times during 5 years Assam to know the minds of the people of Assam. So during election time, you can visit so frequently. Now this Assam, these people are drowning there. You have no time to visit there. No, any other central ministers has also visited Assam this time. These things I have today raised in the parliament.
Very good. Sir, now Assam is one of such states which often experience, vulnerabilities to drought and this kind of things in a flood. What are the structural changes you expect from a government like BJP so that the Assam, they can not only save people from such emergency crisis and can also reduce the, damage in future?
You see, this first thing is this main root cause is this mighty river Brahmaputra. The entire Assam flood, this is a recurring problem, and because of this river Brahmaputra, this flood occurs every year in Assam. So we have demanded that this flood problem of Assam to be declared as a national problem. Because you see, state government cannot, it is not possible on the part of state government with such limited resource to control the river Brahmaputra. You see, there is everywhere so much of siltation, so much of siltation. Because of this heavy siltation, the breadth of the river Brahmaputra and other its tributaries have come to up. So what happens? The water level has crossed always the embankments. So this is one of the reason. So that's why we this Brahmaputra, this flood to be declared as a national problem. And the Modi Prime Minister and the central government has refused to declare it as a national problem and said that flood is a state problem. A state problem cannot be a national problem. He said But I said, you see, the flood of Assam is not equal to the flood of other states. Because like that Odisha last year, Odisha or is Kerala, you see, this is quite different. Why quite different? This Brahmaputra river, this should be declared as a national river or national problem. Why? The Ganga, they have declared as a national problem. For Gangas, they have taken so many of schemes and thousands
Ganga cleaning.
Ganga cleaning and all these thousands and thousands crores rupees they have given. Now my question is, Brahmaputra is far, far important than the Gangas, because Brahmaputra flows through three different countries. It originates from Tibet, then from Tibet, then it comes to India, and from India it goes to Bangladesh, it touches China also. So no other river in this country which is linked to it international other foreign countries. So this is the only river in India which passes through three different countries of this world. So that's why it should be declared as a national problem. And if it is declared as a national problem, and like Gangas, if this government takes this project, then I think in the long run, the flood problem can be tackled.
You have raised one very important issue, that is water crisis. You talked about the Brahmaputra or Ganga, but the main issue is the water. You know, drinkable water is safe and drinkable water is really rare right now. The entire country is facing. Going forward, I think know that there is one city in South Africa which has gone out of water, out of drinkable water. So water is going to be a big issue for the country going forward. Do you see any national policy with regards to water coming up in this recent scene in India?
Yes, obviously, because you see the water is a, it is a, the groundwater, quantity of groundwater is very limited.
Depleted.
It is very limited, and day by day it is, population has been growing. So groundwater is every day, it is because of this consuming and for other purposes also.
What I mean to say that, do you think that Narendra Modi government should declare groundwater, like water crisis, a national crisis?
Yes, yes, obviously, obviously. Mm-hmm. Because you see in many places, because of this drought also, many districts, many states now are very badly affected because of drought also. And the other states also, there is scarcity of water, safe drinking water is not there. In many places, water is contaminated and arsenic water. So all these factors, so therefore national water, drinking water policy, and this took control the water crisis, drinking water crisis, this national drinking water policy, Modi government should come out.
Sure. So viewers, you are watching Sri Ripun Bora, who is an honorable member of parliament from Assam. So he focused and highlighted two important aspects which his state Assam is facing. Let the flood in Assam should be declared as a national problem, and Brahmaputra, the issue of Brahmaputra should be taken with equal importance as the
Ganga.
Government and policymakers have been giving on Ganga. So thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
So keep watching the Policy Times.